A large helium balloon with a rope has mass m. When a pygmy marmoset of mass half m is holding onto the rope, this whole system, balloon, rope, and pygmy marmoset, is floating motionless in the air. Then, the marmoset begins to climb up the rope at a steady speed of v, relative to the ground. Find the velocity of the balloon while the marmoset climbs. The balloon rope marmoset system, floating motionless initially, tells us that the net force on the whole system is zero. In this case, it means that the gravitational force is canceled by the buoyant force. Since the net force on the whole system is zero, the system's momentum is conserved. Initially, nothing is moving, so the initial momentum is zero. And then the half m has a velocity of v. So mass times the velocity, that's the marmoset's momentum. And the balloon may be moving and at a velocity we don't know. We're looking for this velocity. So we can cancel the m and then solve for vf. We'll get vf to be negative half v. This being negative means it's in the opposite direction, so the balloon's velocity goes downward. What about the velocity of the center of mass of this system while the marmoset is climbing? Initially, the whole system is at rest. There is no motion, the velocity is zero, that means the center of mass of the whole system is at rest. Since the net force on the whole system is zero, the momentum is conserved, that means the center of mass starts at rest and stays at rest. So the velocity of the center of mass this entire time is zero. A person with mass m stands at one end of a flat cart that is initially at rest. The flat cart has a length L and the same mass as the mass of the person. The person then walks to the other end of the cart, and we want to find the displacement of the cart itself in this process. Ignore friction between the cart and the ground. For this problem, it can be convenient for us to look at the center of mass of the system, the person-cart system. Since we can ignore friction, that means the net force on the whole system is zero. And the system starts at rest, that means the center of mass of the system starts at rest. That means the center of mass of the system should stay at rest. For the cart itself, if it is symmetric on the two sides, we can say that the center of mass of the cart itself is right here in the middle. So a simplified way to look at the cart-person system is to say that it has a mass m over here and another mass m over there, half L away. Which means the center of mass of this cart-person system would be right in the middle, right here. So this is the location for the center of mass of this whole system. Because the net force on the system is zero, the center of mass starting at rest would stay at rest. So the center of mass of the cart person system will stay right over here as the person walks to the other end of the cart. When the person is at the other end of the cart, the picture would look like this one flipped over. The person on this side, the cart right here, and the system center of mass right there. But we know that the center of mass is supposed to be staying at rest right here the entire time. That means the cart cannot be right here. This center of mass should be lined up right here. So the cart must be here, the person over here, so the center of mass of the system can stay in place. So the displacement of the cart must be half L.